Up guys, today I'm going to show you how to get remote play functionality on your Windows 8.1 and Windows 10 PC, and you can do this with your PlayStation 4, and you're going to need your PlayStation 4 controller for this. As you can see down here, you need a controller for that, and as you can see it works, and you also need a good internet connection, at least 10 megabits per second. So you're gonna need a really strong internet connection to do this, and you're also gonna need a Windows 8 and Windows 10 PC. So hope you guys enjoy. The thing you're gonna have to do is go to this website, PlayStation4RemotePlay.com, and you're also going to need your PS4 to be at the newest update. So as you can see, I have my PlayStation 4 downstairs, and it also needs to be in sleep mode. And you gotta make sure it's on the new firmware. Sorry if the camera's shaky. Then you're also going to need a Windows 8.1 and a Windows 10 PC. So I'm sorry if you have a Windows 7 or late or earlier. And so this is what you're gonna need. These are the specs you're gonna need. For Mac, also basically do the same thing. It depends on, and it works with all the browsers. So. Click this button to install it on Windows. Click this button to install it on Mac. And then right after that, you'll see the app right here. Once you're done installing the application onto your PC, then the first thing you're gonna have to do is go to a Wi-Fi speed test, check if your Wi-Fi is suitable enough for remote play. Then you gotta make sure if your PS4 is on the newest update, and it has to be in rest mode. So click settings, and then sign in the PlayStation Network. I already have my PlayStation Network account right here. If you have a low internet connection, put it on low and frame rate on high, and click OK. And you're basically gonna see this, and you need your Dualshock 4 controller. Let me unplug it really quick. You're gonna need your Dualshock 4 controller, and you're gonna need to plug it into a USB cable, micro USB. Onto your computer, so I'll show you what it looks like when you're starting.
You also gotta make sure your PlayStation 4 is in safe mode. Sleep mode. So turn it off, and it's gonna look like this. And if it looks like this, it means it's in rest mode. So make sure
it's got everything set up. Once you got your DualShock controller up there, it should look like this. There should be a blue light on it. So once you got everything ready, click start, and make sure your PlayStation 4 is in rest mode, like I said, and it's going to connect, and I'm going to get back to you when it's connected. So, once you followed all the steps correctly, and you got the settings you need, now you have officially connected to remote play. Now, it depends on your internet connection, how fast it will be. Mine's is pretty fast, but I just put on low, and normally it's good, and like right now it's gonna be 60 frames per second. Like in real life it's gonna be 60 frames, but on right now once I'm recording, it's gonna be a lower speed than that. I'm just testing out the speed, and yes, you can play games on here as long as you have a good internet connection, and also as long as they support remote play, so you can play something like Need for Speed. But Black Ops 3 is not kind of like a suitable game for remote play, not because it will work, but it's because of the speed. You're gonna need like a really fast internet connection that will play it at 60 FPS. Something like that's good for it is Need for Speed and Destiny, because they run at 30 frames per second. So just to show you that this works, I'm gonna show you Destiny playing. Now I officially got connected to remote play, and I was able to play Destiny. Keep in mind, if you're gonna play a multiplayer match, I don't recommend playing a multiplayer match because it requires precision. Basically, remote play, it doesn't emulate the actual full PlayStation 4. It's required through the internet, so you're at least going to need a good processor to do this. But remember, I'm running this on an old PC that's running Windows 8.1. I don't know the performance on Windows 10, but yeah, this is a very nice feature. Let me focus. This is a very nice feature
for when you're, for example, if you have family or something, then you can go upstairs and use your PlayStation 4 while your parents are watching the TV. So as you can see, you can go to the menu. For example, if I want to play Battleborn, I can go and start that. Or if I wanted to play Black Ops or Need for Speed, I can start that too. If I wanted to go to the store, I can start all that. And if you guys like the theme in the background, I'll put a link in the description to get it on the PlayStation Store website. So yeah. So basically everything's working fine and smooth because I put everything on low settings. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. And thank you so much for waiting. I've waited a long time for the copyright strike to go. It's still not going yet. It's expected to go away by August, I think. So yeah. So I won't play copyright music in my videos no more. I also won't do music tutorials anymore. So thank you very, very much for watching my videos throughout the past couple weeks. I was able to get everything sorted out, and I was actually gonna plan to do live streams on YouTube, but now I'm gonna start doing Twitch streams, and I will make a video as soon as I'm going to do a Twitch stream. I haven't decided if I am gonna do it yet, but I'm planning to. So thank you guys very much for watching this tutorial. This was how to get PlayStation 4 Remote Play on your Windows 8 PC and your Windows 10 PC without the requirement of a lot of things, without the requirement of actually having a PS4 hooked up to your computer. You can just connect to Wi-Fi and do remote play on this thing. So thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you guys soon. Peace out. Alright guys, peace out.